one of our favorite people back with us, Diane Gottsman from the Texas School of Protocol Business Etiquette Training. We are talking about training to be a good person when you're on an airplane when there are little kids around. I am no good at it.
I can tell.
I'm no good at it.
I bet you scare them when they walk by.
You know what? I might. If, especially I'm sitting there waiting going, is he going to be on my flight?
Or her. Here's the protocol for you when you see this family of six with little tiny children walking by. You don't look at them. You don't glare at them. You don't cross your fingers as they pass by hoping they're not going to stop. You just smile and say a prayer for the mom and dad if it's a long trip. Just leave them be, Joe.
All right. Okay, so far so good.
Yeah. Okay, there's all kinds of little protocol tips. You know, starting with when you get to the gate or actually when you get to the counter, make sure that your name, the name that you made the reservation with is the same name that's on your ID.
Right.
So if you go by Joe, but really your name is David, your first name is David on your ID, there's going to be some problem. You're
going to hold them up. Yeah, because most of mine say Joel A. Bickett, but I go by Joe Bickett.
See?
TSA might not like that.
They may not like it.
Okay.
And for luggage, too. So, you know, everything should be the same.
Good point.
Invest in Ziploc bags. Mm-hmm. You want to put everything in Ziploc bags so it's clear. And I have a feeling when you go up to the security line, you're not very nice.
No, actually, I'm very good going through that. Because if I'm wearing boots, I know I got to take them off. I got to take my belt. I'm ready.
That's
I got
a tip.
All that. Yeah.
Be ready to disrobe. Be ready to take off your boots, your belts. Don't be grumbling under your breath. You know, we all don't want to. You're good?
Uh-huh.
Okay,
I'm good. With that.
That's a check for you.
I'll go through one of those scanners, too, if they want me to.
Exactly. Just get through.
Exactly.
How about if someone walks up to you and says, would you mind switching seats with me? Because I want to sit by my boyfriend, and, you know, it would be better if you switched with him.
Yeah, it depends. I got to weigh each situation. If I could get an aisle seat or a window seat, I might have to go, I don't know.
You get reprieve if it's in the middle, because I think it's not fair to switch middle for aisle.
Agreed.
You know, but if it's window to window or aisle to aisle, I think it would be nice. Okay.
I'm good.
What about, I won't ask you if this is you, but those who are frequent bathroom flyers, they need to get the aisle seats.
Yeah.
Because, you know, if you have to keep crawling over someone. But if you crawl over someone, do you face them or do you face out when you're crossing over them?
I always just scoot out backwards. I don't face them.
You need to face them. Face the person you're annoying. So you say, excuse me, excuse me.
Why? So they can punch me in the face?
Well, look what they're looking at if you're crossing the other way.
Good point.
Uh-huh.
Good point. Okay.
There you go.
Well, I didn't know that. I like that one.
There. That's good.
Yeah. Okay.
And let me see. Okay. If you're sound asleep and the drink cart comes by,
right,
do you want me to wake you up? Or do you want me just to let you sleep? If I don't know you, if we're strangers.
Ooh, that's a good question. I would say probably don't wake the guy up.
That's right. Let him sleep.
Yeah, you
let
want something,
sleep.
You'd be awake and know the cart was coming.
That's right. Okay. So now if you wear headphones, you know, that's an indicator that they don't want to talk.
Okay.
So don't be the incessant talker. Yeah. Don't be reading over someone's shoulder.
Hey, let me show you these pictures
I
got here.
Okay. We could go on and on. How much time do we have?
Yeah, and if they got food, go, are you going to eat that?
And don't bring on tuna, salmon, anything smelly.
Yeah, good point.
Yeah.
All right, we're getting the wraparooski here.
Okay.
So what's our lesson here? It's kind of common sense, isn't it?
It is, but you just have to be courteous. The lesson is be patient, be ready to wait, and just be nice to the person you're sitting next to.
What if the kid's kicking the back of my seat?
So you turn around and you say, you know, excuse me, your son is kicking my seat. Okay. And if they keep doing it, then you say, would you mind switching seats with your son? With that smile, with that genuine smile on your face.
You're so nice, Diane. Texas School of Protocol, business training etiquette, something we all need to know. Diane Gottsman, always good to see you.
Nice seeing you.
Thank you.